Hello there, amazing person. Yes, that's you. Today we're going to talk about timer installation. Do you have a problem or need to install an Intermatic timer switch? This video will help you. A timer switch is exactly what the name says. It controls the power sent to a device and it will turn itself on and off throughout the day in a pre-specified time. Anyone could benefit knowing timer installation replacement. We were called to replace a timer at a client's home. When we got there, we found this mess. So two timers were connected to each other with mangled wires, hot glued to a mass of spiderweb gooey substance in a box of redundant or severed connections, but still attached to a busted device. The homeowner wanted to clean it up. He needed a receptacle to plug in a pump. Also, he wanted to lower the timer closer to the ground, so it will be out of view when the plants grow. He indicated the ideal height and mentioned that the receptacle had to be connected to a simple timer. This simple nomenclature may be all you need to know to figure this whole thing out yourself, but especially for a 120-volt system. Load means the switched power that's carried from the timer to the device being controlled. Line means the constant and unswitched power that's coming from the panel and is going to your timer. Neutral is the white wire through which generally the power goes back to close the circuit. So you remember it is neutralizing it by making a loop. Was this exactly what you need to know? If so, like this video and say something on the comments below. And if you need more detailed explanation about electrical terminology, just ask for it. We make another video about it. This is just the basics for the situation that we are discussing here. So we do this to help you. And when you say thanks, we know we hit the spot. If some of you ask to explain a 240-volt timer controller, just comment and we'll produce a video about it too. Ask for it because I need this job. For my situation, I need a bunch of materials and parts. Here's the list, but you can download it, a PDF list from our website. So search at the description below. We need a new timer, a timer container box, a watertight one gang box, a new GFCI, a weather-resistant plug enclosure to cover the receptacle and the plug, anchors, along with the proper screws, some wire to extend the lines, all new half an inch watertight connections. Now, this is everything that you have to deal with. So these are the tools that you need. A pipe cutter to cut existing conduits, a voltmeter to check if the power is off, a 10-in-1 screwdriver, it's always good to carry with you, a set of pliers so you don't bust your knuckles pushing wires inside the box, a screw gun, drill bits and screw bits for your gun. Most of the tools that I mentioned here you'll be able to find on a link at the description of this video. Now, all you need is the right kind of timer. And here are the options for you. Within the client's needs, he asked us for a timer that's simple. And for that, we have three major options. A mechanical old school timer, which seems to be what he had before, but of another brand. The second option is an electronic 24-hour timer, simple and easy to program and maintain. And the third option is the electronic 7-day weekly timer, but this one is a bit more involved in the programming side and the client asked for something simple. So taking in consideration what the client asked for, we went with the option number two. Now, here's a fail-proof diagram that we made and you can see it here, but if you need to download it, there will be a link at the description below where you can get all the schematics and drawings that you see in this video. For a 120-volt installation, the power comes through your wire, the hot wire, and comes into your timer to terminal 2. From the terminal 2, it is bridged into terminal 3, where the power will be hot all the time, but the timer will transfer it to terminal 4 every time the timer is turned on. From the terminal 4, the power is carried to the device that we are controlling, which we call load. Why? Because we are loading it with power when it needs to run, hence load. Now, at the device, the power needs to come back to the terminal and close the circuit. And that's through the neutral. And it, from the neutral, goes back to the panel. Visit our sponsor's website by clicking on the description below. There will be a page there with all these diagrams, and we will post all related videos that we produced on that subject matter. So you don't go crazy looking for it on YouTube. And if you ask a comment, I will do my best to answer your questions and even make a video response flash style. That's all. See you on our next video.